managed to take out. Oh no, I thought he was going to take out all the units, but look, those two Marines are ridiculous. Yuck, what has he done? How did he lose the three Marines? He lost like all of his drones to the Firebats while the Marines took care of two Mutalisks. He is so far behind right now. I think the game is pretty much won by Piano. What a great attack by Piano this time. And I don't know if I would call that a classical hooking, although it's certainly kind of embarrassing to get killed when you have Mutalisks by Firebats. Look at these Firebats just streaming in. Like, it's nobody's business. That Firebat looks like it's going to go down. All right. So I wouldn't say Hyuk has played horribly, although I got to say Piano's played much better than Hyuk so far in this game, especially with that brilliant attack there. No one usually would do that, but Piano saw the weakness. He saw the Lings were all dead, and he said, well, temporarily, I'm going to have a stronger force. Hyuk is going to have a huge challenge ahead of him against Tupei's Terran with this many turrets. He's lost a couple of his initial Mutalisks, too. I mean, you saw that. Three Marines with one medic, I believe, killed two Mutalisks, and the third one was forced to retreat because, I mean, Marines with medics are just that powerful. In small numbers, even. They're just ridiculous. Against small numbers of Zerg units. Oh, man, what was that? Oh, Hyuk! Is this the old Hyuk we're seeing? The Overlord just getting killed by a turret for no reason. I guess it might have been the Overlord grouped with the Mutalisks. I'm not sure what he was doing, but he just walks it into turrets and he loses it. I think at this point, Hyuk is pretty much dead and out of this game. And we're going to see, you know, how many mistakes he makes more. I don't know if I'd call that Ling attack a mistake. I would call part of his defense a mistake. I think he could have focused on the Firebats actually more effectively because the Marines weren't going to do as much damage as the Firebats, which, like, killed every drone, I mean, in his natural and probably some in his main. Looks like he's going to try to micro against these Marines. It's going to be very hard on this flat open ground here, which is actually going to benefit the Terran this time. Usually it benefits the Zerg. Yeah, at this point, I'd say Hyuk is a 1% chance of victory at most, unless he's going to show off some yellow Arnak-like skills, and I don't think yellow was this far behind. He is going to kill a lot of Marines here, but without necessarily the best Mutalisk micro, as we saw there, a little bit of a hesitance at the end, and a couple hits that, you know, just didn't happen. Yellow Arnak, of course, beat Flash in an MSL group a few seasons ago. You should look it up. It was in the round of 32. Look up Yellow Arnak and Flash MSL. And I think you'll see it in my account where he basically destroyed Flash with two hatchery Mutalisks when Flash had two solid bases up like this and just slowly picked him apart in a way that we thought was completely impossible. Or at least I did. I think I was the only one commentating it. We do have a possible Lurker transition here, but I do believe this is too late. There's just nothing he can do against the vastly superior economy of Piano. He's probably drawing double the amount of resources per minute as Hyuk is. And as you can see, Hyuk is down to just these small groups of Mutalisks, and they're not going to be able to stop an advancing force here. Hydra's out. No Lurker aspect seen yet. We're probably going to see just a straight-up push pretty soon. Or perhaps Piano's going to wait for tanks. He really, at this point, can just go, I think. And he might actually catch the timing just perfectly. He looks like he's got about a dozen Marines and a couple of medics. These Hydralisks might be forced to be used before their turn to Lurkers, which is going to be just slaughter for them. And Hyuk is looks like he's trying to just find some kind of angle to kill off a couple of stray units, but it's not happening. I don't think it will happen at this point. I mean, Terran pretty much just has to, like, just build some tanks, and then just A-move towards Hyuk. I mean, Hyuk should not be able to micro well enough to kill that many Marines and units. I mean, this kind of economy, basically. Hyuk is nowhere near a third base, either, you should notice. He's basically going to have to just try to do something with Lurkers and Mutas for two bases. I don't think it's going to happen, though. And there are four Lurkers there. All the Lings have not been used very well this game, I gotta say. Has not been an example of great Ling play. It has been a great example of perfect Terran timing, I gotta say. Getting that sunken and perfect timing. Hyuk unable to do some kind of Lurker trap. That may have been one thing he could have done to get somewhere. Oh no, instead of not just a Lurker trap, he's going to just run his Lurkers all the way to the north. It would have been really sad if he had lost them. Alright, there is the Lurker trap. There's the Lurker trap! Is he going to set it? What? Hyuk, let it go! Oh, finally Hyuk lets it go. And he's going to get some Marines there. Oh nice, he's going to get a lot of Marines. Damn, that was a pretty good move there. I don't know if that's enough, but oh wow, look at this. He's getting all the Marines on the map here. That was a damn fine lurker trap. He actually waited for the one of the perfect possible locations and timings for it. That was not what I expected to happen. It is not necessarily going to get him back in this game, though. Like I said, it was a 1% situation, and it's still a very low percentage, whatever it is, just because of the economic difference. But I got to say, that was an example of something the old Hyuk never would have done. The old Hyuk would have just probably done try to do it, and then he would have either not stopped them, or the Marines would have just run over them and gone somewhere else before he unstopped them. I'm serious. Like, that's what the old Hyuk would have done. Or he actually would have just died by now, just because his drones would have started attacking his own hatchery, and he wouldn't notice for about 10 minutes, and they would kill him. Kill the hatchery, and he would GG. It looks like we got ourselves a... yeah, that's not going to work, Hyuk. Two siege tanks versus two tanks. I mean, sorry, it's two siege tanks versus two lurkers. The tanks are going to win that one. Yeah, I mean, Hyuk is basically doomed, but I got to say, that was a smart move there. He did get a little bit lucky that the piano ran right over it with all of his units, and that was just crazy. Very, very effective lurker trap there. It's unfortunate that he was so far behind because, you know, certainly that could have been something that turned the tides. Although now I don't see him doing that. I mean, he still has not expanded. And he GG's right here. Yeah, Hyuk knows it's over. Hyuk plays a decent game against the Terran again, though, so I won't quite say that the 8-game winning streak was a fluke. However, it has been broken. Hyuk's winning streak broken at 8 by a Terran player, by Piano. Certainly, he's got to be happy that, you know, he managed to break perhaps a Rising Zerg Stars winning streak. And Hyuk can't be unhappy with this game. I am going to cast one more Hyuk game coming up very soon, so I hope you guys enjoyed this one. There haven't been a lot of amazing matchups, so I'm doing some of the funner ones, and I hope you guys have enjoyed, you know, watching Hyuk play again, and we'll enjoy another one. So, see you guys in the next game.